To fit the brace, unfasten all straps, including the AMS strap. Ensure proper alignment of the device on the leg. Height positioning. Align the center of the hinges slightly above the middle of the kneecap. Side positioning. Center of the hinges should be at midline of leg. The condyle pads should lightly touch the medial and lateral condyles of the knee. The device is pre-assembled with thick condyle pads and is included with thinner sized condyle pads, along with a hook and loop shim. Use any combination of the condyle pads and shim to widen or narrow the width. Start by fastening the AMS strap snugly to aid in brace suspension. Note, all straps can be adjusted and/or trimmed to length. Then, stabilize the device by loosely attaching the lower thigh strap. Next, snugly fasten the shin strap by inserting it through the slot in the calf subshell while centering the shin pad on the shin. Fasten the upper thigh strap by inserting it through the slot in the thigh subshell. Center and affix the hinges at the midline of the leg by fastening the lower thigh strap and centering the lower thigh pad, and then fastening the rear thigh strap. Remove the numbered sticker, as the patient will not adjust this strap further. With the patient standing up and leg fully extended, place the required shear knob in the diamond-shaped hole on the spool of the dynamic tensioning system, the DTS. Slowly turn the selected shear knob clockwise until it breaks, and then discard the two pieces. Ensure that the DTS is centered between the shrouds with equal cable length on each side of the DTS. Place the supplied sticker over the DTS. Remove the device from the leg and unfasten the DTS from the AMS liner. Turn over the DTS to expose the underside. Insert a pen or screwdriver into the hole in the pawl and apply outward force in the same direction of the arrow to disengage the pawl from the spool. While maintaining the disengaged position of the pawl, pull the cable out of the DTS until the DTS slides freely on the cable. Turn over the DTS and reaffix it in its original position on the AMS liner. Ensure that the cable is of equal length on each side of the DTS. Place the desired shear knob into the diamond-shaped hole on the spool and slowly turn it clockwise approximately half turn to lock the DTS onto the cable. The cable should be loose but of equal length on each side of the DTS. Repeat the device application instructions to fit the device and retension the DTS. The device comes with a 0-degree extension and 105-degree flexion installed in the hinges, and includes the additional flexion stops of 90 degrees. Peel condyle pads from hinges to reveal stop slots and retaining screws. Using a screwdriver, remove the retaining screws and slide out the unfastened stops. Insert desired extension and/or flexion stops. Secure the stops with retaining screws and replace the condyle pads on the hinges. Do not over-tighten the retaining screw.